Years ago, your independence wasn't allowed. Only good for cooking and cleaning up the house. Only known for being a housewife wearing gowns. Went from dependent to the most independent girl around. Your discipline with your diligence, I respect that. Equal rights for the sexes, we all accept that. Random guys with her number, she might expect that. But if he's not on this grind, she might reject that. It takes a boss to date a boss lady. Got what it takes to date a boss, baby. Yeah, bro, sexy, that's a boss lady. Know how to carry a sex with your boss lady.
In news today, one of the topics that I wanted to make sure I brought up was, of course, the election, and not just the people who are running, but actually the fact that people need to make sure that they are registered voters. This is one of the first days that begins March madness, people preparing for and getting ready for, and one of the things you should be making sure you're prepared for and ready for is being registered. So as a registered voter, that actually gives you the opportunity to make sure that your vote counts. And you all know what March Tuesday is, which is going to be March 1st. That is the first preliminary voting date for who's going to be front runner for the Democratic Party and who's going to be front runner for the Republican Party. And from what I understand right now, I'm getting a little twitch, which means Tayla is in the building. Tayla Andrea, why don't you come on out here? Hi. Glad you can make it. Please have a seat. So, are you a registered voter?
Of course.
Okay.
So one of the things that we definitely want to inform your viewers on is, so I'm a registered independent, and in order to participate in this year's election, mm-hmm. I had to change my status from independent to Democrat in order to vote.
Okay.
So what does that mean? What are the laws? How does that work? Great question. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I won't lie. But I had to, they sent me a letter in the mail in order for you to vote.
Well, that doesn't even make sense though, because they have an independent party also. So is something weird happening with the voting this year?
I just met the deadline by like a few hours, mm-hmm. and I still don't get it. I still didn't, you know, I've reached out to our politicians. We have Ayanna Pressley and Sonia Chang Diaz live on Tuesday. So these are questions that we'll get answers to on that day. But
and before we don't get a chance, mm-hmm. on Tuesday, these people will be on your show.
Yes.
How can people make sure they're tuned into the show?
We have an app. You can download the Big City 101.3 app on your whatever phone that you use, your play area. Download the app. You can tune in on TuneIn Radio, or you can listen at a later date on mixcloud.com/wakeupwithtaylaandre.
Okay, so that's totally interesting because I understand Bernie Sanders is an independent Democrat.
Yeah.
So maybe that's why, because
no,
he's still a Democrat?
And it's all independents across the United States. Whether it was only Democrat and Republican, all independents have to change their status. If you're a Green Party, if you're, no matter what party you're in, if you're not a Democrat or Republican for these primaries, you can't vote.
What?
Why? We'll find out by Ayanna Pressley and Sonia Chang Diaz on Tuesday.
Wow. All right. What do you got for me? We've got a couple minutes.
Oh, Lord. Yes. Okay. So there's a student in St. Louis, third grader, who attends the Gateway Science Academy.
Okay.
Brilliant individual. Mm-hmm. But due to the 1980s, when the schools were segregated and the 1983 U.S. Court of Appeals set into law that all schools must remain segregated. In the actual book, they have that this young man cannot attend because of his color. And it says that students have to move to this district, and in this district is a charter school.
Mm-hmm.
And in this district, they cannot be black.
Whoa.
Like, literally, they cannot be black, in black and white. And
oh, you're going to have to bring that to us so we can make sure we share that on social media.
It's crazy.
Because then what's the point of desegregate? So they're trying to desegregate.
So
or they're trying,
during
that
time,
segregation is separate.
Yes. And when they were trying to desegregate, they were trying not to have more black students come into the district. If any other students were coming into this school, they had to be white students. So that way we can remain desegregating these schools.
Mm-hmm.
But the law has been on the books for so long that in 2016, a little black boy can't attend the school because he's black.
So that, are they saying they have too many black students and he's outside of filling the quota?
This is one of the things that we say on air all the time. Policy, you have to alter policy.
Wow.
It's all about what's in the code, the laws, the bylaws. That's what actually represents change or lack thereof.
Wow. Okay. What else do you have for me? I like to go ahead and let Tayla run with the news piece because she's got so much on her show.
Yeah, and there's a lot that we don't even get to cover half of the things we want to cover, Britt, because there's so much going on, and it's just like, where's the time? So right now here in Boston, the current AMI, the average median income or area median income for Boston, the city, is $74,000 as of 2014. Do you make $74,000?
I sure don't. Where did they get that number from?
I don't make that either. I don't think you do either. But right now in the city of Boston, the area median income is $74,000.
Wow.
Now 30%, which HUD uses for their regulations, 30% is a little under $22,000. So unless you are making $22,000, you can't apply for a lot of these low-income houses that are being thrown up across the city.
Wow. You know what? So because you had ran a little late, I'm going to keep you here, and we're going to talk about some more news towards the end of the show. That way we can go ahead and meet with AXO members and chair member and co-chair member. So I'm going to kick you off for now. We're
going
to cut to a brief PSA, but we're going to go ahead and towards the end of the show, we're going to go over some more news pieces.
Absolutely.
Okay? You don't mind staying?
No.
Okay, perfect. We're going to cut to a brief PSA, and when we come back, you all will get a chance to meet Miss Aziza Robinson Goodnight and her co-chair. We'll be right back.
Don't look at me. Your hair's a bit frizzy today.
Aww.
You should pick that up.
Oh, you're such a dork.
Loser.
Here, let me help you with that. Oops.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Oh, look. Your crush is looking at you.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how.
See, no one here is going to help you, because no one
Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
If you store your guns properly.
So not just anyone can get to them.
I'll feel safer when I'm playing outside.
Safer when walking home.
I won't have to tell so many family members. I'm sorry.
I won't hear as many scary stories.
Or scary news reports.
I won't have to hold someone's hand and shout, you're gonna make it.
And I won't have to tell my kids, this isn't a drill.
Please.
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 Do it for us.
For us.
Do it for us.
Your family, friends, and neighbors are all counting on you. Never let your gun get into the wrong hands. If you own a firearm and are not using it, please be responsible and be sure that it's stored in a safe place. Remember, always lock it up. For more information on firearm storage safety, visit ncpc.org.
Thank you for staying tuned to Boss Lady News. I am very excited once again to let you all know more about the NAACP's one of the committees, which is the AXO program. And I love this program because it focuses dearly on the young people and making sure they get the attention and recognition that sometimes they don't get, especially for their talents. So I'm going to have Miss Aziza Robinson Goodnight come on out here and Mr. Jovan Williams. How are you?
How are you?
Very good. Please have a seat. So nice to meet you. I hug everyone. Please do have a seat. Now, Aziza, we've had you on before, but I know so much has kind of happened and changed and baby and life and more. So we want to get a chance to talk some more with you, but let's focus on AXO and this new chairperson that I'm going to get a chance to meet. So first, let's tell the audience a little bit about AXO.
Okay. First, I'll start with what AXO is.
Mm-hmm.
AXO is the Afro Academic Cultural Technological Scientific Olympics for high school students.
Wow.
It's a 20...
Wait, say that one more time.
Sure. it's the Afro Academic Cultural Technological Scientific Olympics.
Wow.
And it's a intellectual Olympics for high school students. It's 27 categories, so it spans the maths.
I'm so sorry, I know we're live, but I'm gonna have you guys switch seats just so I can hear you a little bit better. I'm like so clogged up right now that my ears are acting a little funny. Now this organization, what does it do, the committee?
Okay, so the ACTO committee are charged to run a full-blown program, mm-hmm. pro bono, which is awesome because the work of the individuals that actually work on this program, mm-hmm. It shows their commitment.
Wow.
So it's a 27 categories, so we are charged with having students, mm-hmm. Pairing them with mentors, mm-hmm. Running a competition, having enrichment activities for them.
Okay.
And also working with them to fundraise to send them to the national competition if they win.
Oh, wow.
Locally.
Wow.
So it's the maths, the sciences, visual arts, performing arts, entrepreneurship, and culinary arts.
And culinary arts. Mm-hmm. Oh, I love food. I love the food. So when you all are kind of pairing these young people with mentors, how does that happen?
So it happens in a few different ways. If the student is already working with the existing like teacher or outside program that takes their skill in a different way, mm-hmm. then that could be their mentor. Or we might have mentors. So you're going to meet Raven Guerra. Mm-hmm. Her mentor is a poet, Ashley Rose. Mm-hmm. And that was outside of her academic time. So you'll meet that too. So there's different ways that we pair them with mentors. They might have somebody, an educator at their school. For example, Adrian Niles, who
yes.
was the
had a chance to meet
yes.
multiple times.
Our gold medal winner, mm-hmm. he actually worked with his teacher in his shop class to engineer that mechanism.
Yes, yes, the segue that he had put together, mm-hmm. incredible. Mm-hmm. And I know you're opening up doors for these young people, and obviously more young people are invited to come and be a part of the ACTO program, and there's almost like, is there a waiting period? Because I know people sign up and there's a registration, but is there also a waiting period?
Not really a waiting period. As we figure out how to run ACTO, because the ACTO Boston was dormant for a little while, mm-hmm. and we're figuring out over the last few years, we've been figuring out how to actually sustain it and have it moving. There won't be a waiting period. So as soon as students sign up, we'll pair them with a mentor, and then we'll work with them on making sure they can actually compete. And they have to compete at a high level.
Okay.
So it's not just a program for somebody who just wants to slide by. It's a super woman, superman competition.
Wow, really? Introduce me to your new co-chair.
Yes, so this is Javon Williams.
Yes.
Javon has been a part of the ACTO committee since 2013, so since I started.
Mm-hmm.
And he's now progressed to being our co-chair.
Okay.
Works.
How are you?
I'm doing great, and you?
Very well. It's very nice to meet you as well.
Nice to meet
you. So what originally got you involved with ACTO?
As an NAACP member, I look for frequent opportunities just to help out, see where I can and assist. This young lady approached me. I loved her energy. I loved what the program stood for. As she said, it was a dormant program. And we were able to just jumpstart it in 2013. Ever since, I just felt that it was a great, competition and something to be part of in helping our young people.
Absolutely. And you'd mentioned that you progressed into co-chair. So were you originally NAACP member?
Yes, I was just a member of NAACP, different, committees, and for this committee, just volunteering, and I just kept on volunteering, and here I am.
Wow. So, what keeps you going with ACTO?
It's commitment to our young people. That's really what it comes down to.
Mm-hmm.
Seeing them compete at a high level, and just sharpening their skills and bringing that home. I thought that was just great to be a part of.
Wow. What are you seeing is one of the main leading kind of segments or programs, not programs, but out of the categories.
Oh, categories.
What's one of the leading categories in AXO?
When you say leading categories, do you mean like most interests, or do you talk about, are you talking about locally, are you talking about nationally, or are you talking about the one that we've gotten the most, the best result from?
First, I guess, then, from Boston, we've got so many, education's huge here in Boston. And from the young people that are signing up with AXO, what category are more of them signing up into?
I get a lot of, it's the range. I think because there's so many categories and it really takes, it's like a Superman or Superwoman sport. I get, we've gotten a wide range, so you don't get, entrepreneurship is big. We also recruited from Build, which has entrepreneurship, and there's a lot of entrepreneurship programs for teens here in Boston.
Wow, okay.
So we have had the most in entrepreneurship.
Okay, and when you participate in AXO and you're working with these young people, what do you feel is their drive?
Just to succeed. They all have that, you know, drive just to, you know, improve, just be better in everything that they're doing. They want to showcase their skills. Again, the young lady that's going to come and join us on the set, she is a great poet, and she's ready to share it with everyone. Mm-hmm. And just seeing her, you know, up there, proud of her craft, and you know, proud to, you know, to showcase her skills. That's something that, you know, I definitely want to support.
Yeah, we don't often give, I feel like, the young people enough attention when they are doing something well. You know, they get that bad, you know, what you doing? Why aren't you doing this? But we don't often give them the, you know, go ahead, you're doing really great, keep going, let's do more. Do you ever feel, and I guess this will be my last question for both of you, do you ever feel like you're giving them an attention that they're not getting at home?
I don't know about not at home, but one of the things that, there's a quote that we've been using, highlight my strengths and my weaknesses will fade. So it might not be that they're not getting it at home, because everybody has different situations.
Absolutely.
But we're just highlighting their strengths.
Nice. And excellent. For you?
It's just giving them a stage, again, just to highlight their strengths, as Mrs. Ziza just stated. And like I said before, these young people, they want to showcase, you know, what they're about. Mm-hmm. And that's what we have here for you, and that's the purpose of AXO.
Well, I want to say I thank you all for this, because I know I've told people about it, and I know people are watching this show, and thank you for supporting and watching the show. So if they have some young people that they want to sign up for AXO, which is a committee with the NAACP, how can they get in touch with you all?
They can reach us via email, and it's bostonaxo@gmail.com.
Absolutely.
That's the best way. Or they can go into the office, the Boston NAACP office, and there are applications in the office.
And the office is located?
500 Washington Street in the Washington Park Mall.
And you all are very welcome to walking in or calling. I know my first intro to NAACP, I'm like, I've been calling for 2 weeks and no one's called me back. So I know you all are busy, but I also know that someone's always in the office to yell at. We're going to cut to a brief PSA, and when we come back, we're going to get a chance to hear from Miss Raven. She is one of the young members of the NAACP's AXO committee. So we'll be right back.
When you're out there, there's no telling what you'll find.
I see it.
Oh, look at you.
There are some moments only the forest can inspire. Find yours at discovertheforest.org.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move, so I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
I love taking care of my mom.
It wasn't easy at first. She learned how to better communicate her needs.
And you learned how to not ignore yours.
I discovered how to make healthier meals.
And I discovered how much I enjoyed them.
Becoming a caregiver is a learning experience for everyone. Find articles, tips, and tools from experts and others who have been in your place. The Caregiving Resource Center at aarp.org/caregiving.
Get caught buzz driving, and you could do some hard time.
Craig, knock it off.
Sorry, Mom.
It could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. And that could set you back a few years. Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
We taught him how to hit a baseball. How to hit a receiver. The strike zone. The net. You taught him how to hit the upper corner. You even taught him how to hit the open man. How much time have you spent teaching him what not to hit?
They say that when you're facing extreme danger, your life flashes before you. If you think that's sad, consider facing it before you even have enough life to flash before your eyes. Car crashes are a leading killer of children 1 to 13. Deaths and injuries can be prevented by using the right car seat. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to know what is appropriate for each age and size.
Thank you for staying tuned to Boss Lady News. Like I said, we're going to get a chance now to meet one of the members of the NAACP's committee, which is known as AXO.
And this just because I swear, break laws, and act hard, doesn't mean I'm a bad guy with extreme thoughts. In fact, I come from a society that says I'm a fall if I don't do the things that are considered wrong, or even if I try my best to stay strong. In fact, we were meant to break laws and steal from y'all. According to my knowledge, we were robbed and beaten like dogs. Then y'all called it the law and gave us a book about a man called God. You said he's our ruler and we'll worship him sooner. Sooner than later, then pass him to your neighbor because he will show you what's right. And at the end, just follow the light. I mean, that sounds nice, but what about my life? Like, do I even get a night to enjoy what I like? Which was wrong to even think. Well, y'all laughed at our wounds and in them, y'all poured drinks. Hopefully you can see where I'm going with this thought so potent. So let's let it marinate while I introduce the date. I'm 1998.
Oh, wow. Oh, my goodness. I've got chills, and my hair is sticking up. I wasn't expecting that, and that's exactly why I did not want to know what was already inside of your poetry. I had a feeling that it was going to be good.
Yeah, I try. I actually got inspired to write that poem while being in a shop of, like, that, like African attire, mm-hmm. which is where this shirt was made, actually, from Luji. If you don't know Luji, she has
Blue Hill.
Exactly. Yes. She has the shop over there called Back to the Roots. Everybody should definitely visit that shop. She made this shirt from scratch, literally. Wow. I brought her the fabric all the way from Africa, and she made this for me.
Okay. Now, what inspired you to not just, I mean, have you always been writing?
So since I was younger, I've always had some type of passion for poetry. But then as I got older, I actually started a class that was focused all around poetry, and they actually made me feel more comfortable with talking about how I feel within my poetry.
Wow. So you have always been into poetry. First, something I always try to ask people, are you originally from Boston?
Yes.
Okay. Where from?
Everywhere. All my life, Actually, I've been to New York a couple of times, but I've never really, like, really left Boston for too long. I always moved Roxbury, Mattapan, Dorchester, all over.
So you're from the New England area, and as a young person, I know I've got a 15-year-old who has written, and I was just seeing with Aziza and Javon, parents don't always encourage the creative side, because the first thing we want to do is make sure our kids are doing right. So when we see something doing wrong, we're like, you're doing wrong.
Yeah.
Did you receive that motivation to keep up with your poetry, or was this something just inside of you?
I mean, this was definitely inside of me, because this talent is like something that nobody really knows about me. Outside of the poetry side of me, everybody thinks I'm this, you know, this street kid who talks with slang all the time, you know, that's dope, this is dope. I don't really show this side much because a lot of people kind of shut it down.
Wow.
Because poetry is often one of those skills that is kind of boring.
Mm-hmm.
Not to me.
Mm-hmm.
At all. I love it.
Some of our best rappers, I mean, Tupac Shakur is my favorite down far, especially when it comes to the lyrics in his music. And he never said he was not a poet. And people now study his poetry because of what he said. And you touched base on a few things within the piece that you said as you were coming out. And I think that's powerful because there's a movement right now. There's a Black Lives Matter movement, but there is a youth involvement in that. And I feel like you're totally interested and ready for that. Do you feel like you're also a part of this movement?
Definitely. Actually, yesterday I was at school, and I've been hearing, like, I know a little bit about Marcus Garvey,
mm-hmm.
but I noticed that you say his name and people are like, who's that?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, all right, I started doing a little bit of research yesterday, and I learned that he led I forget what it's called, but he led a
Back to
parade.
Africa.
Exactly,
mm-hmm.
exactly. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna remake it.
Yes.
I'm gonna remake it here
wow.
in Boston. That's my idea.
I encourage you.
Definitely.
And
definitely.
I'm sure there are other young people that would be encouraged by you also. So what would you say for any of the young people out there that are going to be inspired by you?
Definitely contact me. My Facebook is Zippy Lou Johnson.
That, you're a Johnson?
Yeah.
Oh, my people.
I want everybody to add me. I want everybody to talk to me. I want everybody to reach out to me because I feel like a lot of people want to be able to do it, but they don't have the right resources. They don't know the right people. I'm very open. I love to meet new people. I love networking. I will inbox anybody. You inbox me talking about let's get with the march and let's do it. I definitely, as long as, you know, it's appropriate, that's it.
Absolutely.
That's
I like what you just said, as long as it's appropriate.
As long as it's appropriate, that's it.
So can you give me another piece?
Okay. So this piece is called Where I'm From. I'm from the land of givers. Blankets made us victims of slaughter, yet we still giving to these killers. I'm from my ancestors' graves. We rising, still shining, man, look what y'all done made. I'm from the roots of my roots, my wool sometimes twisted. I'm not ashamed of breaking these boots. I'm from Medzuka Bwanji, cock-a-doodle-doo early in the morning. Amaya, look, that's from Malawi. I'm from Jesus and Nat Turner, our first slave ship and Snow's mass murder. I'm from the headphones and beats, listening to these rhymes because Lord knows I can't read. I'm from making a change, civil rights marches, yeah, we all living the same. I'm from education is key. Christopher Columbus found us, but we only learn in white history. I'm from fighters and believers. Little do you know we two steps ahead and we ain't giving up either. I'm from where we cherish life. We never forget where our history lies. So will you believe me when I tell you that I'm from my third eye?
I'm speechless. Very few young people know much about the third eye, so I'm already highly impressed with this NAACP committee member, AXO committee member, and I applaud you.
Thank you.
And I encourage you to keep going and do more. And I encourage you to introduce yourself to schools and let them know what you do and that you'd like to be a speaker, because that would probably be the next best thing for you to do, in addition to you running for the gold medal for your poetry.
Yeah.
So thank you for coming on, and I'd love
thank
to
you
have
for having
you on
me.
Again.
This is I'm honored to be here. I've never done this before, so thank you so much.
Oh, we're going to cut to a brief PSA, and I enjoyed it. I hope you all got a chance and really listened to what she was saying. And when we come back, we're going to get a chance to meet some more awesome people. And we're going to talk with Miss Aziza and Jovan one more time, just so you all can understand where they're coming from and why they're doing this. We'll be right back.
A full life measured in seats starts with the right ones early on. Car crashes are a leading killer of children 1 to 13. Learn how to prevent deaths and injuries by using the right car seat for your child's age and size.
If you store your guns properly.
So not just anyone can get to them.
I'll feel safer when I'm playing outside.
Safer when walking home.
I won't have to tell so many family members. I'm sorry.
I won't hear as many scary stories.
Or scary news reports.
I won't have to hold someone's hand and shout you're gonna make it.
And I won't have to tell my kids. This isn't a drill.
Please.
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 Do it for us.
For us.
Do it for us.
Your family, friends, and neighbors are all counting on you. Never let your gun get into the wrong hands. If you own a firearm and are not using it, please be responsible and be sure that it's stored in a safe place. Remember, always lock it up. For more information on firearm storage safety, visit ncpc.org.
Okay.
Thank you for staying tuned to Boss Lady News. I can't stop breathing in from the words that she actually said. And I guess I make the mistake too, the perception of what we have for our young people, especially for, you know, young people of color. We look at them and the first thing we think is they're drama. They don't have anything good to say. And I'm so inspired just by knowing that she said she's doing research on these people and what she's writing, and I can only imagine how you all feel about this.
Definitely. Raven actually was one of my first students in AXO, so Raven competed from the beginning.
Wow.
And I've seen a progression, and she was, again, a member of the NAACP already.
Mm-hmm.
She was already involved, but she got into AXO and she competed, and this is her third year competing.
Wow. And there's a level of expectation that you all have for these young people. How do you get them to understand that?
I think our young people actually understand it once they sign up and we tell them what this competition is all about and the expectations of, you know, not only competing here on a local level, but competing nationally. Just as Aziza said, we've had Raven for, three years now. And she's even taken it further, even when it comes to her schoolwork.
Mm-hmm.
High school student, high school senior, now is taking college courses.
Wow.
So she excels in everything that she's doing right now, pushing herself further, not only just in AXO, but in just in life.
Yes. And again, the expectation that we have of our young people, I feel like is so low. And what you all are doing with AXO is raising the bar, really, for these young people. And like you said, they're Superman and they're Superwoman that want to take on this field. So, I mean, what do you say to them when they're like, I'm tired, I don't want to do this anymore, I want my weekend, I don't want to worry about this?
AXO is not super strenuous on them, so it's not like we're taking them every single weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Their talent, their skill is up to them.
Okay.
But there are times when students are not up to it, and we just, like we said, we highlight their strengths. It's not about raising a bar to any standard, it's
mm-hmm.
how great they already are, and just thinking of them as that.
Wow. I think it's great. Joining the NAACP as an adult, you joined the NAACP, you joined the NAACP. This is my last question, and then we're going to cut. What made you join?
I went to a black college. I understood the work of the NAACP. I understood that there was work to be done here in Boston, and I wanted to be involved in that work. So I joined, and I sent my resume to do some other work, and the AXO committee was open.
Nice.
And I, in the committee was dormant for 5 years, and it's not easy. It's not easy thing to revamp.
Yes.
But I enjoy it and I love it.
What made you join?
For me,
NAACP.
NAACP. For me, it was just, you know, the members that were there. One of the big people, Michael Curry, our president. Mm-hmm. He was big in me, you know, becoming involved in NAACP. So, and I thank him and all the others that supported me.
Wow. All right. We're going to cut to a PSA right now. We're going to bring Ms. Tayla Andre back out when we come back so we can go ahead and get a few more news pieces. And then you all know Marco. He's my trainer. He's going to be coming on to the set, and we're going to be doing some workouts. I don't know what he's going to have me doing this time. So hopefully you'll be at home. Get your water right now. Get into your sweats and be ready because he'll be out and he'll be working out with us. We're cut to a PSA, and when we come back, let's hear some more news with Tayla Andre.
Hi, may I please have an application? Thank you.
Skip the drama. Get your diploma. Take that first step towards a better future. Find free adult education classes at finishyourdiploma.org.
So good to see you guys.
So, what's up?
Oh, we finally bought a place.
Holy cow.
You seriously have enough saved to do that?
We've been putting a little aside each month.
Jeez, by the end of the month, we have nothing left to save.
Yeah, I have no idea where it goes.
Well, you're mm-hmm. spending a lot on...
Is it good?
Oh, God.
Oh, how is my account overdrawn?
When it comes to financial stability, don't get left behind. Get tools and tips for saving at feedthepig.org.
Don't cover your mic. Thank you for staying tuned to Boss Lady News. I'm over here fiddling with Miss Tayla Andre. And I wanted her to go ahead and give us some more pieces. And what do you have? What else did you have that we didn't get a chance to talk about?
Okay, so I know we're strapped for time. So really quickly, Ray Allen is coming out, opening a restaurant in Miami called Grown, and Grown, exactly, because all the food that he is going to be offering is grown. His son is battling type 1 diabetes,
and
he said that it was so difficult trying to find food, fast food out here for his child to eat that he said, I'll just create my own.
So our boy from the Boston Celtics, I'm sorry, I don't care about him being on any other group.
Team, exactly.
He's creating his own
restaurant.
Healthy food restaurant.
Fast food restaurant.
Wow.
Drive-through fast food.
And it's fast food.
Yes.
That is new. There's no place that has fast, healthy food.
No.
Wow.
No.
I love it. We're going to go? Are we going to go?
Of course. What?
That's the plan.
Let's go.
We're going in September.
That sounds like a plan.
Yeah.
That works.
All right.
All right, next. All right, so really quickly, Jane Elliott, Brown Eye, Blue Eye Experience.
Okay.
You don't remember Jane. Mm-hmm. So Jane, 25 years ago, was on Oprah. And she was talking about brown eyes, blue eyes, and the experience that she had with her students and making these blue-eyed children finally, for once, feel inferior. And teaching them what it's like to be black in America, or the minority, gay, lesbian. And she was on air, and one of the things that I would like to mention is the fact that she said, I asked her about ADHD and how she felt as a once third grade teacher mm-hmm. about ADHD. She said that if we had somebody who could diagnose dyslexia, more than half of the students that are currently on medication for ADHD will be sat down with a teacher to learn how to correct or deal with their dyslexia. So to all the parents who, teachers, the administrators are like, oh, your child's ADHD, go get them tested. We mm-hmm. want to test them. We want to put them on pills so we can get more money.
Mm-hmm.
Dyslexia. First and foremost, have them tested for that first.
And there are so many young people out there that
young people, girl, I'm dyslexic and didn't even know it.
No, I didn't, first of all.
I didn't know it either.
But there are so many young people out there that are being misdiagnosed in general. And when these young people are being misdiagnosed, they're also being prescribed incorrect or inaccurate medications.
Absolutely.
And I, for one, am 100% against medications when it can be treated with some kind of understanding and proper understanding.
The baby who just read the poem said, and I can't read.
Mm-hmm.
We can attribute that to maybe your teacher didn't sit down with you and teach you the beginning phonics.
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 Phonics is no longer in the school education, and I've got a problem with that.
At all. Well, next in the news, shout out to Blackish for their new show on
Really?
Hope.
I didn't even, I stopped watching, I didn't want to watch, I had a problem with Blackish.
Okay, you have a problem with Blackish.
The title.
Yeah, that's probably the only thing. Watch the show, you'll fall in love.
Okay.
Because they hit every single nerve that's supposed to be hit, and they do it in a comical way, but yet in a respectful way, but it also opens that third eye that everybody was talking about. I love Blackish. Shout out to Blackish for the show on Hope. Shout out to Melissa Harris Perry. She said, I am not a token. I am not a mammy. I'm not a little black bobblehead. In respect to MSNBC taking her show, pulling her hours from her, only covering political issues and not hitting the issues that she hits on so well for the past 5 years.
Wow.
Mark Zuckerberg as well. Shout out to him for, they have this wall that everybody writes on. And he's like, listen, black lives do matter. The next person who crosses out Black Lives Matter won't have a life here at Facebook.
I like it.
I love it.
I like it. And Mark Zuckerberg, thank you for that.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Wouldn't expect that, but.
Not at all.
Not
especially from,
him.
From this mogul. He
but
was a
he
college
does have
mogul.
An other, he does have an other wife, so. His wife's Asian.
Well, we're going to talk about that next time. All right, you all. We're gonna go ahead and let Miss Tayla Andre from
Did
Big City 101 point. From Big City
101.3,
and we're going to let her go,
yes.
And every show you all can catch her on Boss Lady News for the news segment, and you can also find her every morning 5 to 7 a.m. And Freaky Fridays, which is the Friday that I tend
not
to mention.
Better not bring your
We're going to cut to a brief PSA, and when we come back, I hope you guys got your water, and I hope you got your sweats on, because it's time to work out with Marco Ivester.
Hey.
We'll be right back.
Get caught buzz driving, and you could do some hard time.
Thank you. You got a king?
Go fish!
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
We taught him how to hit a baseball. How to hit a receiver. The strike zone. The net. You taught him how to hit the upper corner. You even taught him how to hit the open man. But how much time have you spent teaching him what not to hit?
So good to see you guys.
So, what's up?
Oh, we finally bought a place.
Holy cow.
You seriously have enough saved to do that?
We've been putting a little aside each month.
Jeez, by the end of the month, we have nothing left to save.
Yeah, I have no idea where it goes.
Well, you're spending a lot on...
Is it good?
Oh, God.
Oh, how is my account overdrawn?
When it comes to financial stability, don't get left behind. Get tools and tips for saving at feedthepig.org.
Don't look at me.
Your hair's a bit frizzy today.
Aww.
You should pick that up.
Oh, you're such a dork.
Loser.
Here, let me help you with that.
Oops.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Oh, look. Your crush is looking at you.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how.
See, no one here is going to help you, because no one
Teach your kids
you.
How to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move. So I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
I love taking care of my mom. It wasn't easy at first. She learned how to better communicate her needs.
And you learned how to not ignore yours.
I discovered how to make healthier meals.
And I discovered how much I enjoyed them.
Becoming a caregiver is a learning experience for everyone. Find articles, tips, and tools from experts and others who have been in your place. The Caregiving Resource Center at aarp.org/caregiving.
Thank you for staying tuned with Boss Lady News. I hope you guys are ready. I'm officially ready. Marco, what are we doing today?
Today, I think I'd have a little, we're going to work some chest, we're going to work our triceps, so it can look real nice for the summertime. We'll do a little bit of core also, okay? So, ladies, first and foremost, I just want you to, quick warm-up. We're going to do a dynamic warm-up. We're going to lean forward.
You guys in the studio, if you could please get some music for us whenever you're ready, okay?
And what we're going to do is we're going to raise it up, and we're going to form a formation of each letter. So it's going to be an I, come up, back down, a Y, back down, then we go T. Again, we'll speed it up a little bit. I, Y, T. I, Y, T. These are the dynamic workouts you want to work that helps warm up the body. Ladies, a couple more times, please.
Keep going.
Yep, just to warm up the body. You want to warm these muscles up before you get going. You do this always before you start the workout, okay? All right, ladies, first thing we're going to do, the lovely thing we call a push-up. We can stop right now. Stop right now. What we're going to do is get into a push-up formation. For some people, different skill levels is what you're going to do. If you're not used to doing push-ups, you can do them on the wall, which is a modification, or on the knees. As so, I'll have Britt demonstrate. Just turn to the side, Britt. On her knees, just make sure your back is nice and straight out like that. You can bring the feet up a little bit. And she'll go down and up like that. And I'll do the traditional push-up. Ready? And go. Down. 10. 1.
Oh, God.
2,
how many are you going to make me do?
3. 4.
I'm already behind.
5. 6. 7. 8, 9, and 10. Whew. Good, good. That was pretty easy, pretty easy. Nothing to worry about. They're like, they ready to do another 10 more. But now what we're going to do now, the tricep. Now, we don't have weights. You don't need weights to do some of these exercises. So what we'll do, I'm going to demonstrate real quick, ladies. We'll lay on our sides. We're laying on the side. We're going to put the hand on top, under the armpit. Other hand on your tricep. You will push up, as so, and we'll go up and down 10 times. Got an idea of it, ladies? Oh, looking good over there, looking good. That's 3, 4.
Ooh, I feel this.
Yep, 5. 6, 7.
Oh, Marco, you came to challenge me.
Oh, yeah. 8. 9. And 10.
To
go to one side, we must do to the other lady.
All right, let's go.
Once again, hand under the armpit, right there. Other hand right there, we're going to grab, and we're going to begin again. Ready, ladies?
Yes.
And go up, 1.
Of course my right side's stronger.
2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7.
Whoop.
8. How we doing back there?
I'm rocking.
9.
I'm gonna get this last one out.
And 10. Good job. Ooh. Good job.
Let's clearly, I need to work out more often.
Hey, not a problem. Just goes to show you can do these at home. You don't need weights to get strong.
I like to see determination. Make anything around your house. Use chairs. Use dips. Some other good things for your triceps also. Push up from anything. Elevated to feet inclined. All different ways.
Okay.
Next, we're going to get into a little bit of abs.
All right, ladies.
Yes.
So I'm going to have you all do, first and foremost, a couple in and outs. Hand will be behind. You reach your feet out. You punch them into your stomach. We'll do that 10 times. It'll look like so.
Okay.
You push up. 1. 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. And 10.
Ooh, I like those ones.
Big as your mic. Big as your mic. Now I'm going to go lay back on the sides of you. We're going to get our obliques.
Okay. Now, everyone, I want to thank you for staying tuned to Boss Lady News. We're going to do this exercise out. Feel free to stay with us as we do.
Come check me out at Get Strong with Marco.
Get Strong with Marco.
Hand on the ground, just down on the bottom. And then go to the side of your head. Do a crunch of weight on the floor. This is a tough one, but give it a shot if you can. Go just like so.
Sultan.